Lichen refers to a leaf-like branching appearance, and planus signifies the flat-top nature of the bumps that characterize the condition. Lichen planus is an autoimmune inflammatory condition that often targets the skin, but can also make an appearance inside the mouth. The precise cause of lichen planus remains a bit of a medical enigma, but several factors are thought to contribute to the development. These include genetics or family history, medications such as beta blockers, viral infections like hepatitis C, spicy food consumption as an aggravating factor, and stress, which can worsen symptoms. With these triggers, most affected are individuals between the ages of 30 and 60, with women being more at risk. The pathophysiology of lichen planus starts with immune activation, where keratinocytes, which are cells within the oral mucosa and skin, present with an unknown antigen to the T-lymphocytes. These T-lymphocytes infiltrate into the skin and oral mucosa, where they start to attack the keratinocytes. These cells then self-destruct in a process called apoptosis, and because this process is occurring in the superficial area of the oral mucosa or skin, we then end up with these lichen planus lesions. This will often result in symptoms of itchiness and pain. Lichen planus can manifest itself in various ways and types in the oral cavity. Reticular oral lichen planus is the most common type and is usually asymptomatic. It features a lacy network of white lines on the mucous membranes inside the mouth. The erosive type is a more severe form that presents with red swollen areas and sometimes even painful sores or ulcers, which usually heal with scarring. Papular OLP, or oral lichen planus, appears as small raised areas or bumps that may or may not cause symptoms. The plaque-like OLP appears as white patches that resemble leukoplakia. It is often found on the inside of the cheeks and the sides of the tongue. Then there's the atrophic type, which is characterized by areas that appear thin and red. This form is often accompanied by a burning sensation. There is also bullous lichen planus, which is a very rare form, and it presents with fluid-filled blisters that may rupture, leading to painful ulcers. Diagnosing oral lichen planus involves a multifaceted approach. This generally starts with patient history and then clinical examination. For oral lichen planus, the unique appearance of the lesions often provides strong clues for the diagnosis. Additional tests may be necessary for confirmation in some cases. These include a biopsy of the lesion or blood test to rule out other conditions. A biopsy is particularly useful in diagnosing erosive or more severe types of lichen planus, as it provides a microscopic view of the affected cells. Lichen planus is often a chronic condition without a definitive cure. However, many treatment options aim to manage symptoms effectively. Non-surgical treatment is often the first line of defense, and it includes medications like corticosteroids, antihistamines, and sometimes immunosuppressants. Lifestyle changes and supportive therapy measures can also be beneficial. This includes avoiding triggers like spicy foods or irritants that can exacerbate the oral symptoms. While rare, a surgical approach may be considered in severe cases. These ones are usually resistant to medications. To summarize, lichen planus is a complex autoimmune inflammatory condition that often targets both the skin and the oral cavity. Its pathophysiology involves the activation of the immune system, particularly T lymphocytes, that mistakenly attack the body's own cells, the keratinocytes. Diagnosis usually involves a thorough patient history and a detailed clinical examination, with additional tests supplementing diagnosis when required. While no definitive cure for lichen planus exists, effective management is attainable through non-surgical treatments. This can include medications and lifestyle adjustments, with surgical interventions reserved for more severe cases.